Hey, what's up? I'm Luke, and today I'm going to show you how I take screenshots. It's the common functionality in Mac that's already pre-programmed in there, but I'm going to show you a couple shortcuts and ways that I edit the default settings to make taking screenshots a bit faster. So let's get started. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to do Shift-Command-5, and I'm going to go to Options, and I'm going to deselect Show Floating Thumbnail. Now, normally, if it is selected and I do Shift-Command-4, it'll show the thumbnail, but if I need that file, like let's say I go to Slack, it's not on the desktop yet until I move the thumbnail away, if you just saw it come up. So I don't really like that delay, so I go ahead and take that off. So I'm gonna do Options, Show Floating Thumbnail, and deselect that. Okay, so let's go through them. So Shift-Command-3 will take a screenshot of your entire desktop. I have two monitors, so it'll take, I have my laptop and my monitor, so it'll take screenshots of both. Okay, Shift-Command-4 will create a screenshot from a selected area. Boom. Pretty cool. Now, my friend Mandy Owen and previous colleague, she taught me this. Shift-Control-Command-4. Okay, so it's the same thing as Shift-Command-4, but instead of creating a file, it puts it on the pasteboard. And I use this a ton, because let's say I'm in the Productivity Shop Slack channel, I could just push paste, and then now the file that I just took a screenshot of will paste. Now, Shift-Control-Command-4 is quite a keyboard shortcut and requires two hands. So what I do is I use BetterTouchTool to remap a better key sequence to that keyboard shortcut. I'll show you how to do that right now. I don't know why I've been doing this lately, but it's a thing. We're going with it. Okay, so I'm going to open up BetterTouchTool. Boom. I'm going to go to All Apps, and you can see my key sequence here, and we're going to start from the beginning. So I'm going to disable it. I'm going to go to the plus sign here. I'm going to do a new. I'm going to make sure I'm in key sequences. Boop. So let's start over. Key sequence, plus sign. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do these two keys right here. Control Shift. Here, let me give you a little view. Hands modeling. So what I'll do is I'll use these two keys, Control and Shift. So I can use my pinky and the previous finger, boom, and then I'll activate that keyboard shortcut to take a screenshot using the selection and paste it from the pasteboard. Okay, so I'll do key sequence. I'll do Control Shift. I'll do save, and since it's modifier keys, you don't have to deselect or delete type characters after recognition. I'll go to click here and select action. Click no action there, and then send keyboard shortcut. So it's Control Shift Command 4. I'll go ahead to the BetterTouchTool menu and restart BetterTouchTool. And then I'm gonna try it out right now. So let's say I was in Design Inspiration, which is another site that I really like. I wanna send this to my friend. I'm gonna do Control Shift, and the crosshairs come up. I'm gonna go ahead and select it, and then go to Slack, and I just do Command V. Boom, it pasted. It comes in handy a lot for sending messages, text messages, and Slack messages. But anyway, if you have any questions, feel free to email me at hello@theproductivityshop.co, or you can join the Productivity Shop Slack channel at prodshop.co/slack. Thanks so much for watching. See you later.